Good morning to everyone on Friday, 26th of June, nearly another month gone. This morning, I was kind of going back to memories. I started some memories yesterday, and no problem asking the first question, but perhaps pretty pleased I'm not in the same room with you as I ask the second question. The first question is, have you ever heard the phrase, meanwhile, back at the ranch? And the second question would be, do you remember where that comes from? Do you know where that comes from? Might be a safer question, because then it doesn't mean you had to be in that era. Meanwhile, back at the ranch comes from the silent movies. And perhaps silent movies were the films with the original subtitles as the conversation was taken on by the writing underneath and the music being played by the piano at the side. But when the young woman had been kidnapped from her family and was being tied to the railway track, there was that phrase, meanwhile, back at the ranch, and you were taken back to the homestead where they were realizing with wonderful expression that their loved one had gone, and realizing just who had taken her and what might be happening. And so meanwhile, back at the ranch took you to the other side of the story and the other people involved, who would then, of course, arrive at the railway track in just in the nick of time to untie her before the train arrived. Meanwhile, back at the ranch. Not so much used in that context today, to be fair, but is sometimes used if we're in the middle of a conversation which has gone off track, which has gone off somewhere else, a bit like most of our Bible study conversations and discussions, to be fair. And sometimes it's, meanwhile, the passage says, but meanwhile, back at the ranch, you know, where we should be and where things are still going on, even though a lot of things happening outside this, let's get back to topic and let's get back to the conversation that we started with. So it's changed its meaning slightly. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, just to bring us back to reality and where we should be and what we should be thinking about. Over these last few weeks and months, we have understandably been poring over the news, the local news, local, national, to see what's happening, to see what's going on with the pandemic, how the phases are being rolled out, what might be happening with the R number, all those things, all those different things which most of us had never heard of a few months ago. But now we're quite au fait with talking about these things and measuring them off and seeing what's happening. But we're also poring over the detail and the ever-moving ground of detail and no detail, trying to work out what it is that we are able to do, can safely do, and then thinking what it is that we want to do within that. And what we think that means for us. And the number of opinions on every part of that are immense, myriad. And it's right that we have to be looking at that. But meanwhile, back at the ranch, or actually meanwhile, back in the world, there is a big world out there where things are happening too. And it's not that global news has stopped, it's just that sometimes perhaps it's a little bit more buried than it used to be. It's not the headline news that it used to be. And perhaps sometimes we personally don't have the time, perhaps, but the energy and just anything that's required to connect with other news. And yet the world news needs still to be part of our decision making day by day. We get some from World Mission Council or Faith Forum Impact, whatever it's called these days. But we get news still from the world through that and through the international news on our televisions, because there is still a world out there. And it's a world which is also facing a pandemic. Many countries much less well equipped than we were even to face it, to deal with it. And there's other news out there too that perhaps is trying to get buried or forgotten or not noticed or seen. And it is thanks to me, perhaps, especially or particularly in this case, thanks to Facebook and social media, that these things do pop up on my screen. And thanks to the Church of Scotland and World Mission and other folk who draw attention to things that are happening, which would otherwise just go by the by and we would never notice and never see. And there's lots happening. The one thing that's happened in the last couple of days, which has caught my eye, made me think, gosh, things are getting done, decisions made, which perhaps we don't have a direct control over, but we need to know because it will affect our decisions and how we live and what we buy. It's breaking news, I think was it just yesterday, that Nestle are no longer involved in the fair trade. And, you know, you read, can read between the lines and you can look back and it'll all be economic and it'll all be this, that and t'other. But it does remind us what fair trade is there for and what it means. And perhaps we need to remind ourselves of that. Fair trade is quite simply about people being paid a fair price for their produce. And that can be global and local. Fair trade is also about shopping locally and for local producers, rather than just going to the shop that's local to you, but local producers, giving them a chance, using the produce where we are so that it doesn't have all these miles to travel. And it may involve paying a few more pence for whatever it is we're buying. And if we can afford that, that's fine. If we can't, that's okay too. You can buy what you have to. But if we can afford it, then it's for those of us who can afford that to stand up strong for fair trade locally, but also globally. Because the global fair trade is all about not just a fair price, but about giving producers and farmers and communities a say in what they grow, in what they make, in what they sell, in how they produce things, and with a premium to help that community to build itself as a proper community with proper conditions for workers. Because when we're not fair trading, whatever brand you want to follow and resource and check it out carefully, but it's about helping people to live lives well, not in a slave trade, not being taken advantage of. Can you imagine if someone came in and told us what it was that we were to be doing with our lives, what we were to produce, and then how much they'd pay us for it, even though that price wasn't fair and we just had to accept it. Can you imagine? Can you just imagine? So it is a decision over which perhaps we might say we have got no hold over this. We can't do anything about it. But we decide where we spend our money and we decide what we buy. And it may be that Nestle produce our favourite biscuits for taking a break. It may be that we think we could never live without them. I think we could. And I think the only way that we are going to make that felt by producers is if we truly take a stand and raise our heads and realise that back in the world, back at the ranch, back in the world, there are decisions being made that are not in our name. They're not being made in our name, to be fair. But we've got a lot of things to do locally, minutia to pour over, forms to fill in. But meanwhile, there are people out there being taken advantage of. There are people locally, businesses locally, who are going under because local produce isn't being bought. Time to truly support local and global. And do what we can. There are people who are saying that as we are becoming a virtual church at the moment, we are becoming more activist. Great. I've got no problem with that whatsoever. As long as we don't forget it when we do get back to what we think is normal and back together again. I think this era of change is prompting us to make the changes, the ones that we really do need to see in our world. So meanwhile, back at the ranch, or meanwhile, back in the world, let's make our decisions fair ones to support and help and make a difference. Let us pray. Lord, make us sure of your love for us, so that in that certainty we can live, we can decide, we can use our voices to tell others that they too can be sure of your love. That even when the world around us is changing beyond our understanding, even when we can't make sense of it all, your love holds us sure and firm and gives us confidence. Lord God, give us grace to live our lives mindful of others, our own loved ones, those closest to us, helping them, but also mindful of those whom we have never met and never will. Farmers, producers, modern day slaves trapped by poverty and oppression, and sometimes abuse. Help us to make our decisions with the betterment of all in our sights, in our own community and on the other side of the world. And give us mercy to spread our care to a community and a world that is hurting, as being put down, as being sidelined. Mercy to see where justice is not a priority and money is. Father of all, give us eyes and hearts, minds and compassion to recognize the needs in our world. Help us to do all that we can to make sure there's a fair sharing of all that earth produces, because it is your earth, not ours. Not ours to do as we will, it is yours. Lord, guide us and give us wisdom. Help us to recognize the need for us to pay a fair, realistic price for all that we buy, to ensure working conditions and hours are humane and better than humane, to ensure families can stay together, put food into stomachs, pay bills, and have time to stop and rest, relax and enjoy. God Almighty, we want our world to change. And so we pray that you will change us so we can help to change your world. We give thanks for all that we enjoy in our lives, grateful for the place in which we live, here in Dalgety Bay, where there is wide open spaces, where we have the sea with tides that offer a continuously changing view, hills and woods to enjoy and explore, a creation that reminds us of your imagination and your power and your love. We give thanks and pray that we will lend our heart, our hands and hearts to build and create a place of inclusive love. Father God, hold in your hands all who are being left behind by the decision of others, all who are left wondering how they will cope as income dries up or stops, near and far away, knowing that they will be held and supported by you and by us. God, we pray for vision, for your vision. We pray for love, your love. And that as we know your love, so we will love you and love all around us, and love your creation, showing that love through our word and our action today and always. Amen. Supporting local businesses. We can do that if we will. And our wills are for us to decide, not others. Enjoy today as you will. Sun may or may not come out, the rain may or may not come down, but life goes on and we have much to enjoy and for which to give thanks. So bless you today. Whatever you're doing, enjoy it.